is how Coon got his dinner. Once there was a young frog mother, and this was her first time having children, and she wasn't sure what to feed them. So she went into the forest, and she asked the deer. She said, with her wide mouth, to the deer, "What you feed your babies? What you feed your babies?" And the deer said, "Well, I feed my babies laurel leaves, grass. That's what I feed my babies." And the frog thought, "Oh, I don't think my babies would like laurel leaf." So she went to the birds, and she said to the birds that were on the ground, she says, "What you feed your babies?" "Tweet, tweet. We feed our babies worms and bugs." "Ooh, bugs maybe, worms, So she went to the snakes, and she said to the snake, "What you feed your babies?" And the snake said, "So, funny you should ask, 'cause I feed my babies wide mouth frog." And that frog twirled around, eating every morsel of frog and spinning and humming, good, good. Oh, and he seemed to be in such ecstasy and such satisfaction that the raccoon looked out and saw him chomping away. And he says, "What are you eating? What is so good?" "Frogs. They taste so good. Here's a leg left. Try this." And raccoon tried the frog leg. Yes. That's some good eating. And from that point on, raccoon had an appetite for frog legs. And he knew that down by the river, somewhere a little bit after noon, the frogs would come out and they would start frog legging, jumping and leaping and croaking and jumping and leaping and croaking. And he looked, all the while his mouth was just watering. Ooh, he was getting mighty hungry watching them long green legs just jumping and leaping. With his mouth watering, he grabbed himself a club and tiptoed down into the clearing and started running after those frogs with his big tote bag. And he was snapping at frog legs off and dropping them in the tote bag as fast as he could. Got about a dozen frogs before the rest of them jumped back into the river. And he ate half of them on the way home. He was good and full by the time he got home, but he had about half a dozen left. And his wife made barbecue frogs. And the whole family loved frog legs. And he went back and forth doing it about every day with his big tote bag and his club. But after a while, the frogs got pretty tired of having the legs of their cousins and their daughters and their uncles and their grandparents just snapped off, and the frogs left with a life of having to roll around or being taken here and there by other frogs or just laying there on lily pads because they can't go nowhere. They got tired of it, so they had a big town meeting. I'm talking to all frogs. There was the bullfrog was there, and all frogs in the land came from one. And then they sat down and they talked and said, "We got to do something about this raccoon We had to do something about this raccoon. So they decided what we need is a lookout frog. And we need that lookout frog to sit on that rock right near the clearing. And as soon as he see that coon, he should tell the others that it's coming. And the bullfrog says he had the biggest mouth, decided, I'll tell everybody. And he got up on that big rock. And this self-appointed show-off frog said, I'll tell everybody. I'll tell everybody when it's coming. And so they did. Because raccoon hit that clearing, club in his hand, tote bag open. And when he started rushing for the frogs, bullfrog warned him. Said, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come. And all the frogs ran back into the river, and raccoon ran to the edge of the river, and he couldn't get to the frogs. He was most disappointed. And he ran back. And he hid behind the bushes. And he waited. Till they came out again. Frog and leap and jump and croak and leap and jump and croak and croak and leap and jump and croak and leap and jump and jump and croak and leap. And just frogging it. And all the time, Brer Raccoon watching them frogs. His mouth is watering. He's got this gnawing feeling in his belly. And he clenches his club, and he runs out with his tote sack. And as soon as he hits that clearing, bullfrog goes, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come, ribbit, ribbit, here come. Well, they warn all the frogs, and the frogs run, jump and leap and run back into the river. And raccoon chases them to the edge of the river, but oh, he can't swim. And he can't get the frogs, and boy, is he mad. Oh, he's angry, and he's hungry on top of that. Well, he goes back home, empty tote sack and all. By this time, his wife was like 6 months pregnant, and it had developed quite an appetite for frog legs herself. And that particular day was wanting some frog legs mighty bad. And he comes home, and she says to him, I know that ain't no empty tote sack. It's well past the dinner hour, and you know I'm eating for two, and I'm hungry. Where are my frog legs? I want some frog stir fried tonight. She was so angry, and he explained to her. He said, but please let me plain to you. Let me make it plain to you. He said, well, every time I go out to the river, it's a big bullfrog. And he goes, ribbit, ribbit, here it come, ribbit, ribbit, here it come. And his little show-off twerp of a frog goes, ribbit, ribbit, here it come, ribbit, ribbit, here it come. And before I can get to the frogs, they all leap and run and jump back into the river. And you know, I can't swim. So what was I supposed to do? I tried three times. Well, she was so angry. She picked up a frying pan, and she started backing him up towards that front door. And she said, you better get out there and get me some frog legs. I'm so hungry. And if you don't get me some frog legs, I'm going to hit you with this frying pan. Well, he runs out the door. Gets to the end of the road and starts walking real slow. He was feeling mighty bad, mighty low. Wasn't quite sure of himself, didn't know what quite he was to do. Because he wasn't selling frog legs at the grocery store. He had to get himself. Well, wouldn't you know it? Just when you're feeling low comes a friend. And he ran into his good buddy, Brer Rabbit. Brer Rabbit was walking pretty slow and looking pretty good, because Brer Rabbit knew it was not where you were going and when you had got there, but how you look on your way. And he was walking, leaning to the side. He had one of his zoot suits on, one of his wide brim hats cocked to the side. He was cool and walking down the street. And his friend says, "What's up? I mean, what's your problem? Looking all dejected and whatnot." He says, "Well, every time I go down to the river, because you know how much I like frog legs, the bullfrog warns everybody. He says, 'Ribbit, ribbit, here it come, ribbit, ribbit, here it come.' And that little green frog says, 'Ribbit, ribbit, here it come, ribbit, ribbit, here it comes.' And all the frogs run into the river before I can catch them." He said, "And I go home, and I went home. I tried that 3 or 4 times, and then I went home, and my wife is threatening to hit me with a frying pan if I don't bring her home frog legs. And you know how mean she gets when she's pregnant." Well, he says, "You know what, Brer Rabbit says, you know what? See, you have a problem. See, you're thinking with your belly instead of your mind. See, you need a plan." He said, "What be a plan?" "Well, you know you come to the plan of the man. Sit down, let me think your plan." He said, "This is what you do. You go down to the river, and you play dead." "What? I don't want to die. I just want some frog legs. What's up?" He said, no, I'm not talking about really dying. I'm talking about play dead." "Well, really dying may be what I might just do if I don't get some frog legs and get them back to my wife tonight." He said, no, it'll be okay, because I got a plan for you. You just do what I tell you to do." So frog, the raccoon didn't rightly understand the plan, but he went along with him, because Brer Rabbit was a good friend and was always had a plan up his sleeve and was quite a trickster. He had a reputation for one, so based on his reputation, Raccoon did what Rabbit said do, and he decided he was going to die in style. So he started singing a blues song so he can get all the frogs' attention as he died. And he started, "Dun, dun, dun, I'm going down to the river. I think I like to bang high. I'm going down to the river. I think I'm gonna die. I'm going down to the river. I'm so hungry for some frog legs. I could just die." And he spun around 3 times, kicked his legs up and fell flat on his back. And went, and died. Well, it was real quiet for a while. But one by one, the frogs came out. And they said, "Ribbit, ribbit, frog dead. Ribbit, 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 ribbit, frog dead. Ding dong, frog is dead. What old frog? That old frog." They started frogging. They started having a party. They started leaping and jumping and croaking because a raccoon, who had caused them such miseries, was dead. And they jumped and they danced all around. And all of a sudden, Brer Rabbit came out of nowhere with his loud yellow suit and his floppy hat. And he took his hat off and he threw it to the ground. And he said, "You ought to be ashamed of yourself. This is a good family man. Now he's dead. And you're dancing and partying. Oh, you ought to be shame, aren't you, God-fearing? You ought to at least give him a proper burial." Well, the frogs started feeling pretty bad about the dancing and everything, since Raccoon was dead and he was a family man. They felt kind of bad, although they were happy he was gone. So they decided, the bullfrog said, "Ribbit, ribbit. We'll bear them for you. Ribbit, ribbit, we'll bear them for you." And one by one, they came out with their shovels and their picks. And they went near the rabbit and the raccoon, and they began to dig a hole right next to him. And they went down, 3 feet down, and they said to Brer Rabbit, "Is it deep enough, Ribbit, Ribbit? Is it deep enough, Ribbit, Ribbit? Is it deep enough?" And he said, "Can you get out?" "Believe it can, Ribbit, Ribbit. Believe it can, Ribbit, Ribbit. Believe it can." He said, then Rabbit said, "It ain't deep enough. Keep it digging." And one by one, they were digging. They were digging. "I can dig it, dig it, dig it. You can dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it, dig it. We can dig it. Can you dig it, baby?" And they were digging. And they got down. They got down 5 feet. And they said to Brer Rabbit as they looked up, "Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough? Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough? Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough? Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough?" Well, Rabbit looked down and he said, "Can you get out?" He jumped and leaped a little bit and said, "Yeah. Believe it can, Ribbit, Ribbit. Believe it can." And the girl frogs went, "Ribbit, Ribbit, believe it can. Ribbit, Ribbit, believe it can." Then the rabbit said, "Then it ain't deep enough. Keep a digging. I just stand here and supervise." Well, they dug down to 10 feet below, 10 feet into the ground. And they looked up at Brer Rabbit and they said, "Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough? Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough?" And the girl frogs went, "Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough? Ribbit, Ribbit, is it deep enough?" Rabbit looked down and said, "Can you get out?" They looked at the hole and they started jumping and leaping. They couldn't get out. With a little bit of worry, a tension in their voice, they said, "Ribbit, Ribbit, no we can't. Ribbit, Ribbit, no we can't." And the girl frogs went, "Ribbit, Ribbit, no we can't. Ribbit, Ribbit, no we can't." And the rabbit was laughing and he said, "Then it's deep enough. Raccoon, get up and get your vittles. They ain't going nowhere." And Rabbit threw Raccoon's club and tote bag down. And Raccoon chased those frogs around, snapping off those frog legs. And when he went home to his wife, "Oh," she said, "baby, baby, baby. Oh, I know you love me, sweet daddy." And she was so happy that she made a frog leg feast. Because she was really, really hungry. She made barbecue frog legs. She made stewed frog legs. She made roast frog legs. She made steamed frog legs. She made sauteed frog legs. She made frog leg salad and frog leg soup. Boy, she was happy. And the story has a moral ending. It tells us to look before we leap. As for the frog's end of it, and for the raccoon's end of it, it says that two heads are better than one. And in this story, we learn about the concept of kujichangalia, which is creativity. Where raccoon and the rabbit, came up with a very creative means of getting some frog legs.